forgotten remedies. So this is a very interesting thing that I want to just share with you. The first remedy I want to talk to you about today, and these are remedies we don't use so often, but remedies which have amazing clinical application. So I want to talk to you about Strontia Naka, first remedy. The reason I speak about Strontia Naka because I've used it very often. And I believe I have got the main jinx of it. So strontium ka, we know it's a mineral remedy, and it was discovered in lead mines in strontium in Argishwell. It is crystallic. In homeopathy, it was proved actually by Nenning. And the main symptoms initially were flushing of face, congestion. So it's a very congestive remedy. And better by Wong. And aggravated by cold. But we'll talk about the homeopathic indications a little later. You can see the periodic table here. Strontium ka is here. So let me give you a brief idea of the periodic table. You can see this is the first row, the hydrogen. The second row, the carbon. The third row, natrium, magnesium, alumina. The fourth row, kali, calcarea, ferrum. The fifth row, strontium, palladium, argentum, cadmium, stannum. Sixth row, baryta, aurum, platinum. So strontium is here. It is just below calcarea ka and it is just above baryta. Now why are we talking about this periodic table? Because this kind of strategic position of strontium has some symptoms like calcarea and some symptoms like baryta. So let us talk about it. So the idea to talk to you today also is about how to study Materia Medica or how I study Materia Medica. So first thing I look at is the sphere of action. Actually the first thing I look at is the history of the medicine, where it was used, where it is formed from, who proved it first, what was it used for before homeopathy indication. So a little bit of pathophysiological, historical. I'm a historical person also. I like to know about history. So its special action on vasomotor circulation, heart, kidney, bone marrow, ankles, and especially the right side. Now how do I study this forward? So circulation, it's a great remedy for blood vessels. And that's why hypertension. It's a great remedy for heart, many heart blocks, kidney, bone marrow. That's why I've used it very often in avascular necrosis, ankle swelling. This can sometimes be associated to heart, sometimes it could be a conformity, and especially the right side. This is how I study the sphere of action. I want to take you step by step in understanding this. After that, I like to tell you about Farrington. And Farrington, and I know a lot of people are listening to this. Few of them are students, interns, early practitioners, senior practitioners. But Farrington is a book that actually made me fall in love with homeopathy. The way Farrington, you know, he died at the age of 40. The way he has written about homeopathy and his in-depth knowledge. Actually, Herring had told Farrington that I want you to take homeopathy to the next level. And actually, people say that Farrington was the next generation Herring, but he expired at a very early age. So Farrington very nicely has written, it has more action on circulation than its relative baryta ka. It has flushes, pulsation, but especially threatening apoplexy. So I had a case of stroke, patient based in hospital somewhere in South India, stroke with flushes from behind, with chilliness, high blood pressure, slightest exertion, head flushes. Strontia Naka in high potency put him to rest. Great remedy for stroke. It's also similar to Asterias rubens. Asteria rubens will get pulsative pains, headache. Strontia Naka will get flushes. Just remember the difference. It also has smothering feeling in the heart. So as soon as they light up, this is like Grindelia. Grindelia robusta. Also like lachesis. Also, they have chili headache better by wrapping up, like silica and magnum, Allen scalers. So this is how you compare and contrast. Let's go a little ahead. Strontina Carp, written by Guernsey. Guernsey was the original keynotes master. He writes, there is a very sudden violent start. I believe this is a keynote of carbon remedy research. And they are very chilly and they don't want to uncover. Let's come to Bogar. And first few lines of Bogar are very important. Congestion, fleeting pain. So 1 minute the pain is here, another minute pain is somewhere else. Rheumatism, it's a great remedy for rheumatoid arthritis. I remember when I was working with Sarkar, he told me, Strontiana Carb has better action on rheumatoid arthritis than Prastox with the same indications. Pain increase and decrease gradually. Boric has written fleeting pains. Immobility of one side. This is where I want to talk to you about one of the case of Bogar. And this is written in Homeopathic Recorder. And I like to read these old journals. And I want to encourage you in reading old journals. He had a case of sciatica with swelling of one ankle. And he gave many remedies. Many failed. Finally, he gave Strontiana Carb. He cured the sciatica. This after which has become an indication for Strontiana Carb. Swelling of the feet. Although in repertory, it is written, given by Clark. But I gave this symptom, actually Bogar's clinical symptom. Then we speak about Elizabeth Hubbard. Do we know about Elizabeth Hubbard? Okay, Elizabeth Hubbard was a contemporary of Dr. P. Sankar, one of the greatest homeopaths from England. And she has done a lot of work. But what I like is her writings. And her writings are very beautiful. So what she writes is that the predominant characteristic of Strontiana Carb is vehemence, impetuous, very hurried, violent, passionate. Anything that comes in between, bam, he will just beat it. Quarrelsome, ill-humored, irascible. Very interesting. The way she has written, and I really want to tell you, this article is by Elizabeth Hubbard. There's a book by Elizabeth Hubbard called as Basic Homeopathy. I think it's published by Elsevier. It's fantastic. You'll fall in love. You'll forget many other people. Okay, let's go ahead. Here I want to talk to you about state of mind. And here I want to talk to you about how to understand the mind symptoms. What do you mean by mind symptoms? Mind symptoms means mainly, especially, how we can understand and decode the mind rubrics and understand the drug picture through the repertory. So what I have done is I have studied all the rubrics of strontium carb and I have built a picture which I want to share with you. This is what I call pattern of rubrics, pattern of state of mind. So what I believe is the pattern is that strontium carb get very anxious whenever they do something new. They are very artistic and they are capable, but they are very anxious because they have not done this form before. So they are very scared about how they will do, they will not do. And that is why they will ask someone senior, someone who is well-known in that field for help and guidance. And this is where I tell you the crux of Strontiana Carb is guidance, need for guidance. And now we understand the rubrics. Fear undertaking anything new. Artistic. Very strong responsibility. Very shy. Very busy and fear of failure. This gives it very similar to silica. That's why silica and strontiana carb. In fact, calcarea silicata and baryta carb are very close remedies to strontiana carb. Let's go ahead. The other thing is anxiety. Strontiana carb can get very anxious, especially when they are given targets. You have to do this and this. They will get very anxious. What will happen? What will happen? What will happen? Will I do some mistake? Delusion, crime committed, criminal. they can be very shy, reserved, timid, especially of strangers, especially conscientious. So that's why they come very close to silica and baryataka. But the difference is that they also have a state of carbon, of dark, scared of drowning, scared of light, scared of darkness, want light. Many, many dreams of snakes, water. So this kind of fears make them very close to calcarea. In fact, they are also scared of loss, loss of people who will guide them. There's a very interesting symptom in Allen's encyclopedia, very fretful, is inclined to beat everything that comes in. Forgetful is another very concomitant symptom, just remember. But one thing I've seen, and I once cured a case of rheumatoid arthritis with this, that the patient had so much of suppressed anger and that whenever something would come in between, she would just hit. And especially when someone is not there, she will hit in air. So striking imaginary objects, striking anger, striking from anger, anger suppressed. This is a keynote of Sranchoka, like Stephicide. Let us, and this is what I've seen, a state of mind which is a little bit like Calcil and Barite and Staph with need for guidance. Just try to build the picture. Let's try to understand the dreams. The main dreams, this is a lot of provings have been done by Dr. Sankaran, and he's a major person. He's my guru. And you can see this small image that I keep in my place. You can see Dr. Sankaran in the middle, and Dr. Sarkar and Dr. Vijay Vaishnav. And these are masters, absolute masters. So they get dreams of guidance. They want advice, dreams to be guided. So they will get very, very attracted to guides, attracted towards parents, relatives, saints, gurus. They are also very sensitive about being given credit to someone else. Actually, strontia and akam don't want appreciation, they want credit. In fact, Dr. Sankaran has written very nicely, and I want to just decode what he writes. He has written, strontium represents the age of adolescence. This is the age when one ventures out in something new, with full knowledge that if one is faced with problems, they can come back. Strontium carb is for guidance, especially some experienced person can help them. The relationship with this guide is the most important thing in his life, and there can be problems if such a person is missing or guides in excess. So if more guidance, that is also an issue. New task, learning to drive a car professionally. They are very sensitive towards it, but very important, they require encouragement. It's very important. Next, we come to cravings. The main craving of strontium carb is this. You see in front, cheese pizza. This is the craving. Bread, butter, toast. Paneer and cheese. Interesting. Now we'll try to understand the patterns of strontium carb of different pathology. How their headache will be. How their joint problems will be. So first thing I want to tell you about is the headache pattern. The pattern that I see in strontium carb very often is a patient will come to you and tell you that they have headache in the nape of the neck and on the eyebrow, and especially there are flushes, pain comes gradually, goes gradually. They are very chilled, they have to walk, they get tightness with very high BP and desire to smoke. It will give you an idea like glonoin, but glonoin is better by tea, remember. You can see this Patak repertory rubrics of strontium carb. The other important thing is rheumatoid arthritis and joints and osteoarthritis and swelling, sciatica, orthopedic condition. And the pattern of orthopedic condition of strontium carb is joints, very painful. You will see them which are extremely painful. And along with that, always remember the concomitant is diarrhea. Joints with diarrhea. Pains which come and go, they get aggravated at night. Calf pain, which are cramping. Atrophy, dropsy, chill in the back. They want sun. This is very important. Strontium carb wants to be in the sun. They want hot water. Cramped. One side is immobile. You can see this referred to sheet. This is the totality of rheumatoid arthritis, and I use this totality very often. Joint, extreme pain after injuries, one side is immobile, formication on lower side, right sided shoulder, sun ameliorate, time especially aggravated night, rheumatism with diarrhea, multiple neuritis. I've also seen it to be a good remedy in joint pains, especially shoulder joints. Stroke, it's a great remedy for stroke, especially congestion of the head. Like Ratania, it is also a great remedy for burning in the anus. Like amyl nitrosam, it's a great remedy for flushing. Dr. B.K. Bose from Kolkata would use this as a great remedy for any kind of operations or any kind of hemorrhages of the eye. Chronic sequelae of the eye. See, Clark has written very nicely. Bone affection with diarrhea. These are the causations of Clark. Operation of the eye. Hemorrhagic chronic sequelae. It's also similar to carbo-wedge in shock. This is one symptom I use very often. Cramp in the leg of the calf with coldness. Varicose veins. Clinical tip is especially anytime when sprain, when arnica fails, Rustox fails, think about this. Farrington also speaks about a psychotic eruption, especially on the arms, with burning. This is what Nair also has given. Relationship of remedy, it's closest to baryta carb in stroke, silica in headache, Aesculus in walking, and apoplexy anterior rubens. But best work is done by Dr. Sankaran always. Dr. Sankaran has written about proofs, desire to be with friends, with guidance, fear of future, competition, refusing to join new game for want of confidence, and ugly skin eruptions. Massimo has written a lot about duty and sense of duty, responsibility, eruption, psoriatic, especially without itching, and pregnancy ameliorate. Calcarea like fear, silica like shyness, creativity like argentum, anger suppressed like staff. I've used a lot of references, Allen, Slippy, Farrington, Guernsey, Boker, Pulford. I've read about 25 books to understand this core. This is the core of Strontianum. Remember, this is the core. So this is my attempt to speak to you about old and forgotten remedies. Please write to me. This is my email ID. What you thought about our today's talk. Thank you.